So in today's video, we will discuss the anatomical, dynamic and potential territories in flap planning. So it is very important for us to know these territories because they tell us when to delay a flap, when not to delay a flap, and they also help us in effective planning. So as we all know, Cormack and Lamberti have described these three territories, and for the sake of convenience, we will discuss them in a case of a DP. Now I have taken this Arnold's chest for the ease of understanding the anatomical landmarks in a better way. So as always, we begin with marking of the important anatomical landmarks. So when it comes to DP flap, we have the inferior border of clavicle. Then here we have the deltopectoral groove. You can appreciate the cephalic vein entering into the deltopectoral groove. Then we have the perforators of the internal mammary artery. These are the parasternal perforators. I would say somewhere around 1.5 to 2 centimeters from the sternum, lateral border of the sternum. Then in the deltopectoral groove, we have cutaneous perforators of the thoracoacromial artery. More commonly, it is a single perforator. It can be multiple perforators as well. As we go beyond that, we have the cutaneous branches over the deltoid, which are supplied by the deltoid branch of the thoracoacromial or the anterior circumflex humeral artery. So this was about the blood supply in these three areas over the DP flap territory. Now these are the perforators of the internal mammary artery which we have marked. They go along the axis towards the deltopectoral groove, and in this area we have again the perforators of the thoracoacromial artery. So now coming to the anatomic, dynamic and potential territories. Now the territory from the lateral border of the sternum to the deltopectoral groove forms the anatomical territory of the DP flap. So this is the territory which can be safely harvested without a delay procedure. This is a territory which is entirely supplied by the internal mammary artery, although towards the end it has got some communications with the branches of the thoracoacromial artery. But this procedure does not require any delay. This is the safest territory of the DP flap. Now, if we go beyond the deltopectoral groove, that territory becomes the dynamic territory. Dynamic territory always becomes after the flap is harvested. After the flap is harvested, the cutaneous supply through the thoracoacromial branches, which we have marked, is cut off, and this flap is now predominantly supplied by the internal mammary artery with their connections with the thoracoacromial axis branches. Now, beyond the deltopectoral groove, if we have to raise this flap, it is generally said that the ratio of this flap beyond the deltopectoral groove should be in a ratio of 1:1. Commonly, it is seen that 3 to 4 centimeters beyond this deltopectoral groove, the deltopectoral flap can be safely harvested. Now, beyond this dynamic territory, if we are going to encroach upon the branches of the upon the cutaneous supply, or the deltoid branch of the thoracoacromial axis, or the anterior circumflex humeral artery, which would be this area over the deltoid muscle, then that would be called as the potential territory for flap harvest in the case of DP flap. Now this territory we can't harvest without flap delay. So these were the anatomical, dynamic and potential territories in the case of a DP flap. Now this principle is the same all across the body for all type of cutaneous flaps. So if we are familiar with the anatomy, it helps us in the proper planning of these flaps. Now coming to one more important point from practical point of view during flap harvest, it is commonly noted that when the perforators of the internal mammary artery are large in size, then the perforator of the thoracoacromial artery, the direct cutaneous perforators, which are commonly encountered in the DP groove, are smaller. Similarly, the cutaneous perforators or the cutaneous branches of the deltoid branch of the thoracoacromial are also smaller. Inversely, if the perforators of the internal mammary are smaller, then the cutaneous perforator, which is generally or commonly encountered in the deltopectoral groove of the thoracoacromial artery, those perforators are large in nature. So if during flap harvest, when we start flap harvest from distal to proximal, from the deltoid region coming to the sternum, and we encounter large perforator or large perforators of the thoracoacromial artery, then it is better to delay this flap, because if there is a larger perforator there, internal mammary perforators are going to be smaller and our flap has got a risk of necrosis. So under these circumstances, it is better to delay this flap. Now just a quick revision. The anatomical territory is the area supplied by vessel before it anastomoses with other vessels. Dynamic territory develops after flap elevation when a cutaneous vessel is divided, but the original area of blood supply remains viable, and that happens because of rearrangement of local blood flow. The potential territory, as we have already discussed, includes area beyond the dynamic territory and can be only captured after a delay procedure, otherwise it is going to have a sure shot failure.